Everyone wants their baby to be born as healthy and strong as possible. You want him to have a fighting chance, you know?
But when he was born with those two arms, it took its toll on us, as you can imagine.
And here we are, 33 years later. It's still hard to believe he's so gracefully coped with such a horrifying mutation.
You talk to any doctor, I don't care how long they've been practicing medicine, and they will tell you that the hardest thing about being a doctor is, and has always been, informing the family that there's something wrong with their child.
His ideas were so groundbreaking and revolutionary, even I didn't understand them. And I'm known throughout the global scholarly community as a fucking genius, okay?
Perception's a bitch, you know? Say if he was born, like, with swords for arms, you know? Like, say he sprouted a massive pair of white angelic wings, you know? Everybody'd be like, what a badass, you know? But it's not fair to him that he's always got to be the one that's being called out by this, you know, hopelessly idiotic critics out there. They don't understand what he is. So, if you actually got to know him, like I have, you'd immediately realize how much of a good guy he actually is. I mean, he's a fear of Jesus and God and all that commendable stuff, and hard worker, and good, you know, he's just a bodacious buddy, really.
You know, in terms of what he's accomplished, what he's become, who he is, he's really kind of spat in the face of conventional expectation regarding what you can be and what you cannot be being differently abled in this modern society that we live in. What the guy's done for our community alone is unparalleled, groundbreaking even. He's a role model. He's a model citizen. And yes, to answer your pregunta, he's an actual model.
This guy is not just another dipshit asshole who wants to be a spewed out cog in the system.
So what if he's got two arms? Now, I've often considered that he might be the first one to actually achieve the next step in biological human evolution. But people, man, people. History's proven again and again and again and a fucking again that there's something new, people are scared of it. Yet. Because they don't understand yet.
When I think of what it means to be a hero, I think of two things. One, and this is obvious, but I'll say it anyway for your edification, and that's being an American. Two, is a loyal subordination to the very principles upon which this nation was founded. But I've added a new one. Three, two arms. This loyal young foot soldier is the real deal. He's an ass-tearing, body-crunching, terrorist-decimating, M-A-C-H-I-N-E. Can't even begin to tell you how many fucking times that motherfucker saved my fucking life.
He's pretty much sex incarnate.
I'm not gonna lie, I would gladly be the inner lining of his worst pair of shoes just to be close to him.
I just love him so much!
You know, as our extraordinary safety coordinator, for the last 27 and a half weeks, this young man had the unenviable task of ensuring the safety of 300 and change highly skilled, highly paid, highly vulnerable factory floor workers. You know, this kind of facility is not a playground. You know, we used to lose three or four guys a week. We lost a couple of guys. They fell in a vat of acid that we didn't even know existed. We lost a couple of guys in a corn crib There's no corn in our product. We used to have spikes, and they look nice. But before this young man showed up and, you know, brought these things to our attention, we were losing 4 or 5 guys a week.
If it wasn't for him, I don't know if I'd still be alive.
Yeah, man, I mean, I guess he is just the bass player, whatever that means. I mean, I guess that means he is the bass player. Yeah, but to me, he's every player.
It's like when he's playing, it's like not him playing. It's like he's some sort of like cosmic conduit or like a heavenly vessel. Like God's power and love is all coming down from the heavens through his fingers and onto the instrument. And that's how he gets those slaps and pops.
I don't remember him joining. I just remember him always being there.
Yeah. Look, being the Steve of the group, I've had to work my entire life just to become the functional backup bassist that I am today. Just like Ludwig van Mozart, he's a complete, effortless natural.
He's bassastic. He said that to me one time when I was in the bathroom and he was the stall next to me. And he was like, I'm bassastic. I didn't even know what he was talking about. And to this day, I still have no idea what he's talking about.
This guy's the real deal. His ideas, we don't understand them yet. But when we do, we're all gonna be a lot better off for it.
He does things right, he does things tight. He inspires.
I think he uses the arm thing to get attention from women, from men. You name it. I think he's got little to nothing to offer as far as personality is concerned. Those arms are like a cloak, if you will. It's a distraction from his douchitude. I think he uses it so he can go hang around downtown and pick up as much filthy strange as he wants. I mean, objectively, who can resist? I know I couldn't.
I mean, what is a man supposed to do in the world with two arms?
You know, as a black man, this day and age, you're really hard pressed to find that white friend that you can feel good about. You know, because you want that white friend. I mean, everyone does. I think I really lucked up. I mean, this dude can legitimately dance. I mean, he could tear it up. He can tear it down, he can build it up, he can cut the rug, he can drill a hole, he can mash potato gravy, that's James Brown. He can flip it up, down, center, side, every which way.
And that's a real gift. The likes I've never seen in any of my other friends, white friends.
If we're speaking truthfully here, sometimes I wish I had two arms.
No, in this fucked up piece of shit called life, everybody's got an advantage, everybody's got a disadvantage. You know, my name's Tracy, you know, I got a girl's name. And I didn't let it get me down, did I? You know, I come from a long line of men with lady names. My daddy's name was Victoria, okay? My great-granddaddy's name was Emily, you know? And my great-great-granddaddy's name was Elizabeth. No, I'm just kidding. It was actually Emily, too. I really would argue that it made us sexier. Yeah. Yeah, I agree with myself 110% on that.
If the Lord ever put a shit-kicking, fear-inspiring, bullshit-throwing, literal, jihad-killing, military machine with two legs on this fucking green earth, it's that man. A hero. A God-fearing patriot. But above all else, a legend, the likes of which we've never known and never will again.
If I could have fixed him, I would have. but I couldn't, so I didn't. Do I feel bad about that? Well, sure, of course I do. It tears me up every single day of my life. But like some things in life, sometimes you just gotta move on. Not every doctor's perfect. The one thing that keeps me from being totally perfect is that I failed to heal him. That being said, to be fair, I'm not honestly convinced that any doctor could do anything for a patient with two arms. Simply put, he's a medical abnormality, the likes of which did not exist in the human gene pool before he was born. That's just concrete, simple, scientific fact.
This guy right here, he can do anything anybody else can do. And I bet you he can do it better. You know, a lot of people don't believe that, but it's true. You know, I've never seen anything like it. He can swim, drive,
jog, pick up shitloads of stuff, shake a man's hand, shake a woman's hand, shake a child's hand, pump serious iron,
eat a sandwich,
jump, put on clothes, smell.
So you see, the possibilities for my fine feathered friend over here are literally endless. You know, he's just like everybody else. I mean, except for his arms. But you know, I will never, or shall I never, ever apologize for his condition. You know, if ever I'm gonna apologize, it's gonna be for him being too awesome, you know? Fucking love him. I love him. I'm sorry. Hey, I don't know why I'm saying this, but I love him.
Next step. I don't know. President? Messiah? He's already done everything you can think of. What more can he do?